Ranching in southern Alberta is not for the faint of heart and can be a very rewarding business. The people who thrive and survive in this environment have a special bond with the land and with their families, friends, and neighbors. Those bonds span generations and all kinds of challenges. Bill Long was born in the area in 1934 and tragically lost his parents in a car accident. He was taken in by his mother's family, the Varleys, who ranched just southeast of Pincher Creek. Bill and his uncle Henry worked the land together, raising top-quality Hereford cattle. When Henry passed away in 1990, Bill took over the ranch and grew the family business. Bill remained a strong supporter of rural life until his sudden passing in 2013. In addition to his own community contributions, Bill established a bursary for agricultural technology students at Lethbridge College. He further wanted to honor his uncle and the Varley family for their many community contributions, which date back more than a century and include donating the land on which the Fishburn United Church now sits. His bequest to the Community Foundation will be known as the Henry Stuart Varley Fund for Rural Life, an endowment that will forever support people who have an interest in building and sustaining rural Alberta communities.
Stuart of the land, that's another thing that he was very good.
Frank Jenkins is a lifelong friend and neighbor and now owns the original Varley family ranch.
Well, I think everybody wants somehow to leave a legacy, and I think that with Henry and Bill, neither one ever had children, neither one was ever married, so this was a way that they could leave a legacy and promote rural living in southern Alberta and have opportunities for young people. Bill wasn't interested in the legacy for himself. He was much too humble for that, but I think it was for Henry.
Maxine Bodgner is Bill Long's cousin. A lifelong southern Albertan, she grew up on an area farm and remembers Bill as a quiet man who genuinely cared for people, his cattle, and the land.
Oh, I'm sure that he wanted to see the rural community continue and to prosper, and people that were starting out in it that didn't have as much as they would need to get going, he wanted to help them.
The foundation listened very carefully to what his wishes were, and that when people leave a legacy like he has, they usually do it to improve the quality of life for individuals, to enhance their communities, to be all that they can be, and possibly to affect change. And so I think Bill would be very pleased to know that with the grant, that the money that he has given us, that we will be able to do all of those things. I think philanthropy comes in many shapes and forms. Some people give very kindly of their time, of their talents, of their skills, and others are in a position that they're able to give their money. The board is more than delighted that he did indeed choose the Community Foundation of Lethbridge in southwestern Alberta to leave a legacy with, and we want to celebrate that with our community. We know that the difference this will make to funding in the rural communities over forever, it's a forever gift. And so we know that it's going to make a world of difference, and it's everything that Bill would have liked.
The Community Foundation of Lethbridge in southwestern Alberta was established in 1966 with a $500 gift. Today, the foundation delivers grants in excess of $550,000 to more than 100 groups each year. The foundation serves 12 counties, municipal districts, and First Nations communities, as well as more than 40 individual towns, villages, hamlets, and the city of Lethbridge. To learn more about the Community Foundation of Lethbridge in southwestern Alberta, please visit our website.